When you read your result, you need to interpret it. And interpret doesn't mean that translate from words into from number into words, but you need to explain why you have that kind of number, how you have that kind of result. What does the result say, right? What does the result say to the readers? So you need to spend amount of time to reflect on what your readings, your finding mean to the readers. That is, the readers expect you to make sense of your study, make sense of the number. 80% of the students agree something. What does it say? Why they have 80 number, not 20%, 80%, not 20%, for example. And these number have any kind of correlation to previous studies or consistent to the previous studies? Interpretation of the result refer to the way how you could construct a version of what you think the result means or what you could infer from the result. What does the result mean? Each result, okay, what does it mean? And how could you infer from the results? In this way, you can make sense of the result to the reader with a new dimension of understanding, right? Understanding of the result. Sometimes the common belief is that people believe this phenomena in such a way, but when you get the result, you interpret, you found something new, so you can tell them, right, and explain. You need to keep in mind that, keep in mind the question, why the result occur in this way, why not in another way, or what you could learn from the data. The data, what you could learn from it. Sometimes it is consistent with your common belief, with the common teaching approach or the common theories, but sometimes it might be opposite, and then you explain why. Interpretation is not just simply a description of the results. Rather, it moves to a critical level of reading and analyzing of the result or the data. Remember, critical level of reading. Read the result critically. Do not just say 90%, 80%, 70%. It doesn't make sense. Critically, read that data and say about it. Analyze the result. Compare with the previous study. Use the theory, the teaching approach to interpret it. All the data you collect from the questionnaire or interviews sometimes contradict, sometimes consistent, sometimes make sense as a whole. So maybe sometimes in the questionnaire, the students say no, but in the interview, they say yes. So what does it mean? Or sometimes they say in this way, but come to the interview, they say another way. Or sometimes, even though in one series of questionnaire item, you have 25 questionnaire item, in the question 4, they answer in this way, but similarly, in another questionnaire item, they say different. So you need to put them as a whole, critical and analysis to interpret the number, the data. So interpretation of the data is very important, because that is the way to help you to make sense of your result, and it is the way to help you to find something, to have the findings of your result based of your study based on the result.